David, you know, as a sheep herder himself,
right.
He has a way of talking about God that you really have to have his frame of reference to understand his use of analogy. Points that he makes in Psalms 23.
For example,
sheep, if they should fall over, get onto their backs, they can't roll over. And if the sheep herder doesn't actually get to them quickly, it will stay there kicking and die because it doesn't have the ability to roll over.
Right.
Did y'all know that?
Yes.
About sheep? And so there's meaning to this scripture. Sheep will also not lie down. And the reason why sheep will not lie down, it's for four reasons. They will not lie down if they are afraid. They will not lie down if there is tension in the herd. I'm gonna say that one more time. Sheep will not lie down if there is tension in the herd. The body of Christ. If there's tension, they won't lie down. And then they won't lie down if they are aggravated. Flies and other insects annoying them. And then you'll find, as we get further, where we get anointing from. But I'm going to get back to that. So, and then the fourth reason why they will not lie down is because of hunger. Those are the four reasons why a sheep will not lie down. And so to deal with the aggravation, the oil that we use in church and where we get that from is what the sheep herder will use on the sheep. The oil is used on the ears and nose of the sheep because it then does cause for the insects to be repelled. And if those flies are able to get into the nose of the sheep, it will lay egg.
Oh my.
And the way in which then these sheep then are anointed to prevent for flies, foreign objects, from making their way into the sheep's nose, because you know, if you can get into the nose, you can get into the brain.
Wow.
And so the oil of then the herder, which was olive oil and other spices, but it would cause or it would repel the insect. And so now you have then the understanding of why we say anointed with oil. It's a shame when we start walking with other sheep and we got something in our nose, both of us being anointed, but yet and still we can't do anything for each other. See, we got to get tired of being in church so long that we have folk that we know have things going on inside of them that we know are foreign to who they are. And you can see it through their behavior. You can see it through their depression. You can see it through their sadness. You can see it through what they're going through. And yet we'll all be together as sheep. But the reason why none of us can lay down is because one of us can't lay down. See, he was anointing their head because of the prevention of fly and the prevention of foreign object from getting in the nose, which would get to the brain. And if you get to the brain, then you can kill the sheep. So we have some foreign substances that have gotten into society and climbed up the nose and has now killed us.
Oh, Jesus. Right there.
So if the church were to get out into the street and start anointing, then we might be able to deal with some of the societal issues.
We need to then, as a herd, recognize that, wait a minute. Wait a minute. There ought to be a difference when we come together. There ought to be some power that comes out of unity. And if we started representing, reflecting the unity that comes out of being together as believers, maybe there might be a comprehension and understanding of what unity should look like in society. And so when we leave this herd, we have to go out into that herd. And we have to start laying some stuff down for folk.
come here, baby. Let me anoint something on you. Let me drop this here on you. Let me drop this here on you. If I can't pick you out of a lineup of other prostitutes, you might want to check your uniform. If you got yourself on Facebook. And in your post say how much you love God. I'm gonna have to check the uniform because you on the bathroom countertop with your leg open and out. You better check your uniform because maybe it's not your exterior uniform, maybe it's your internal uniform. Maybe it's your self-esteem is. But you're a part of the herd, and so I need to pull you over and let you know that you don't want to put your selfie on Facebook like you're trying to invite somebody over for dinner and you on the plate. Because you are part of the herd. And so if I don't say something to you, then I know that I'm not then using my anointing. You might not listen to me. You might not even like what I said. But I'm not actually going to tell you because I'm expecting you to like it. I'm telling you because it's a necessity. Because as you being a part of the herd, then I know right now, instead of you looking cute, you're really looking curious because you're on your back and like sheep if somebody don't roll you over.
Come on.
So I'm going to roll you over so that you don't die on your back. Literally.
I could have lost my mind. I could have lost my mind. But I made it through. I wish I had a witness. Is there anybody in here that's been through anything?
So glad.
That you almost threw in the towel. But when you look back over your life, you realize I made it there. I made it there. Is there anybody?